Hello everybody and welcome to a new RPG example video. Today I'd like to show you an example of how to make a GET from a REST service using SQL in our RPG programs. Let's go. Well, the first thing I want to show you is the REST server that I'm going to use. I have found this fake online REST server that you also can use to make tests. Okay, let's go and type some code. As always, I have to say that I'm using VS Code with the code for IBMI extension. I have been making this simple program, this one, that I want to share with you. You'll see this is a very simple program. I'm going to make a GET to the REST server, and then I'm going to receive information from the server. I wanted to show you two options. The first option is using HTTPGETCLOB. For that, this is what I had to do. As you see, it is a simple select. I have, in this case, two parameters. The first one is the URL that I'm going to communicate with. And the second parameter is the HTTP header. In this case, the header is not needed, so I send a null parameter. And I have to use a field to retrieve the response from the REST server. Response. Okay, that's all. This way, I will get information from the REST server as easy as this. The second option that I want to show you is using HTTPGETCLOBVERBOSE. Imagine that apart from the response, I need to receive somehow the HTTP headers from the server. Well, this function is used for that. In this case, I will need to change the select using a table with two fields to store the response. The first field is to store the response, and the second is to store the HTTP header of the response. Okay? And I have to use it this way. Basically, I'm using the same parameters, but they are written in a different way. Okay? So let's compile the program and let's go to the green screen to test it. Okay, compiled. So let's go to the green screen. Okay, let's start on the debug session. Okay, let's stop the code here and let's run the program. Okay, I'm setting here the URL that I'm going to use. And the first thing I'm going to do is this GET with the HTTPGETCLOB function. Okay, and when I use it, okay, if I see the response variable, I will see this. And if you see, this is the same that is in the REST server, okay? So it is working fine. If you change this number one to number two, you probably will get the ID number two and so on, okay? Okay, now let's try to use the HTTPGETCLOBVERBOSE option. And in this case, I'm getting a table with two fields. The field number one is response message. And as you see, it's the message that I'm getting from the server. And the second field is the response HTTP header. And as you see, there I have the header from the response, okay? So, as you see, these are two basic options for making a GET to a REST server, and you can use them in a very easy way from your RPG programs using SQL. As always, thanks for watching.